Hi there, and thank you so much for joining us right here on the web. In the aftermath of Sandy, a severe thunderstorm hit, bringing even more damage to parts of the Granite State last night, toppling trees and damaging homes. Good afternoon. The storm spawned by Sandy swept through around 9:30, and the National Weather Service says it looks like a microburst hit the Franklin area, destroying this home. Ray Brewer has more on the storm's damage in our top story.
Residents say it sounded like a freight train, and now in the daylight hours, they can't believe the amount of damage that was done in such little time.
It was frightening. I just heard a crash.
There was a lot of that Tuesday night around Webster Lake in Franklin. Around 9:30, the storm moved across the lake. Some residents say the first thing they noticed was the thunder. Then the winds came, and it got progressively worse.
We actually went into a central room in our house and kind of got down low. We thought for sure it was a tornado from the sound and the things hitting the house.
One person out driving as the storm hit said they had to use the whole road as they dodged trees and branches that were coming down with visibility of less than 20 feet. In the daylight, things didn't look any better. One home in particular took a direct hit.
It's horrifying. I'm just looking at that house over there, and it's like, I hope nobody was in it, because that'd be devastating. It's just, I've never seen anything like this.
Fortunately, no one was home at 174 Lakeshore Drive as two huge pines came down, crushing the home. In fact, many of the homes by the lake are seasonal homes, so they were unoccupied when the storm came through. In some cases, the homes were lucky as the huge pines came down and missed the houses completely. Others, though, weren't as fortunate, and just about every yard or home suffered some damage.
Just structurally, we'll have to look at the corner in there. This one's not quite so bad.
And for as much damage that the storm did, there are also many homeowners who can't believe their luck. This cottage was having foundation work done and was up in the air. The homeowner said for sure she thought it was going to be gone. Instead, it wasn't touched.
It was a huge relief, you know, tears coming down the whole nine yards. It's, you know, still there. It's been in my family for 57 years, and there's a lot of memories there.
While homeowners are still in the process of assessing all the damage, they say, despite the destruction, they're just grateful that no one was injured. In Franklin, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.
Thank you, Ray. We're following a developing story in Ware this afternoon. Police looking for a man wanted for a violent assault on a 17-year-old girl. Police say 22-year-old Jonathan McGuire assaulted the girl last night on Old Town Road and then took her car. That car is a black Jeep Liberty with New Hampshire license plates, the number 210-3374. Police say McGuire is armed and dangerous. He has family in Groveland, Massachusetts, may be headed there. Anyone with information should call police. Sandy has forced News 9 to postpone two of our Granite State debates. Friday will now be a congressional debate doubleheader. Republican Frank Ginta and Democrat Carol Shea Porter will take the stage at 7 at the New Hampshire Institute of Politics, followed by Republican Charlie Bass and Democrat Annie Custer, excuse me, at 8 p.m. The governor's debate is tomorrow night, and you can watch all three right here on WMUR and on our website as well. And starting tonight at 5, we are going to be tracking power restoration and damage assessment. Look at this photo just into our newsroom from one of our crews, a tree shattering a portion of this garage in Litchfield. We're going to be back with team coverage starting at 5. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon.